some spine mobility. You're gonna start with your feet, hip width apart. I've got my shoes on. Your shoes could be off or on. It really doesn't matter one bit. Just kind of loosen up a little bit. This is gonna be really good before an exercise set. This could be really good afterwards. This could be good if you're just feeling really tight and crunchy in your spine and upper back. I know I usually am. And just inhale, really gentle here. And then you're just gonna exhale. Bending the knees and folding forward. Hands on the floor, big knee bend. You can wiggle a little bit and then press the palms and come up and do that again. So exhale down, relax your head and neck. Big knee bend, a little movement. This isn't about being pretty. This is about finding mobility and press the palms and come up. One more time. So just kind of feel what's going on. You can put some nice calm music on for yourself right now as well. And then stay right here in ragdoll. You're gonna grab opposite elbows. Get your torso as close to your legs as you can. A nice gentle sway side to side. I've got my knees bent heaps, you guys. I have super tight hammies. If you're with me, high five. We're doing our best, right? Foam rollers can help, but you know what? Don't fight your jeans, man. Just make them feel good. All right. Big breath in. Big breath out. Come up one more time. Reach this time. And then we're gonna have a seat. All the way down, you're gonna extend your right leg, fix your ponytail, and then you're gonna cross your left leg over your right and come to a really gentle twist. We're just getting started, so don't pull. Sit up really tall and just open to the left side. Think about turning from your belly button. If this feels too crazy, you can uncross your leg. You can be really gentle. It feels good on your spine. A big inhale for length and a big exhale to rotate. Start to tune into what's going on through your back. And then we're gonna switch sides. Lengthening, either pulling the heel close to your behind or take it over. Breathe in and breathe out. Adjusting if you need to by uncrossing the leg, not twisting as far. Do what you need to do. This is about feeling good. This is about opening. It's not about forcing your body somewhere it doesn't wanna go. Shoulders down away from ears. Good, and then unwind. That already feels better. And then you're gonna come just like this. I'm gonna move around different angles. You guys don't need to. Take your hands under your shoulders and your knees under your hips, and then you're gonna breathe in. You're gonna reach your right arm up super high, and then you're gonna exhale. And you're gonna keep moving like this. So inhale up into this chest opener and twist. And then exhale. So work in the thoracic spine, your upper back right now. Try to keep your jaw and your neck relaxed. We're gonna go three times with the right arm. And on the third time, we're gonna stay just like this. Now you decide, you can either stay in this shoulder twist, kind of rotating through your upper shoulder and lowering through your bottom. And you can even reach your opposite arm, my left arm up. But if this feels too rough, don't do it. And then come down. And let's go the other direction. So now the left arm goes up, and then you exhale. Inhale up. I've got my toes kind of tucked. This is about what feels good for you. Again, focusing on your upper back. We have a huge lack of mobility in our thoracic spine. It makes for a lot of discomfort. This is just going to help. This last one we hold. So options again, you can bring your hand back and just really rotate into that shoulder stretch. You can adjust a little bit and see if you wanna reach your top arm up. Oh yeah, breathe. Feel your breath really helps you here to open tight spots, stretch tight spots, and then exhale. Just breathe. And then let go. Okay, I'm gonna show you this from two views. First, you're gonna come back into child's pose. So reaching long legs, hips back towards heels, face goes down, press back. And then you're gonna come through with your chest really low. You're gonna put the top of the legs and the hips on the ground, and then you're gonna reach up. So kind of a Sphinx variation, kind of a Cobra variation. Lengthening your back, think about drawing your body forward and up. And then tuck toes, hands by shoulders, keep the body low and come back. So we're going between child's pose and this kind of cobra lift here. So come forward again, staying low, And you can kind of experiment. If you have a little more flexibility, you may want to come up like this. If not, you're down like this, it's not a big deal. Pull the body forward, just a little bit of traction. You can move side to side. Feel this make space in between all your vertebrae. Heck yeah, man. Through the crown of the head, come down. Push to child's. Make this big, you can wiggle. A little release through the shoulders. Feel that warmth that's happening. Come down. Maybe this time trying a little baby cobra or even coming into upward dog. And if you're not ready, you come back to that sphinx. We're gonna do this one more time. So this is about your flexibility, your mobility. Sorry, I know I do this weird blowing breath. It's really helpful. Try it. Come low this time, almost like a snake. And then again, we're doing sphinx, we're doing baby cobra, we're doing upward facing dog. But we're pulling forward, thinking thoughts about length. Happy upper back, mine feels all warm. Those reaches are just amazing for mobility. Good. And then you're gonna, we're gonna do some work on our back, okay? Supine first. I'm gonna turn side on. I might wiggle around so you guys can see the best thing here. First, you're just gonna take your knees together. You're gonna take your arms out like a T, and you're just gonna go from one side and then slowly to the other, keeping the legs together and trying to keep the shoulders close to the ground. Obviously, if your back or opposite shoulder lifts up in the direction you're going, it's okay. Feel a little bit of a massage on the lower back as you go side to side. I don't want this to be forceful. So breathe in. Breathe out. A couple times side to side. You're gonna feel the lower back here. See if you can get your knees all the way down. I know that can be a little bit tricky. Gonna start to tune into the lower back now, moving down our spine. Let's do one more. And then bring both of your knees to the right. Okay, one arm is down. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take your top arm, you're gonna reach all the way around and over. Coming back again. So you're going all the way around your body, keeping in this side lie position. Can you put your hand on the floor the whole time? It feels so good, you guys. I'm telling you. Don't worry about what your arm is doing. Just try to keep it long. And we're really just rotating. So we're coming forward towards the floor. Then we're opening through the chest and the upper back as we reach in this beautiful circle over our head. Try to rest your own head on the ground. Relax your jaw. Oh, yeah. That's the money right there. Looks little. Feels fantastic. And then we're going to switch. So you get to pick. You want to do that 6 times, 8 times, 1,000 times. I don't care. Let's go the other way. So come forward. Mobility is about what do you have time for? Now, I can right away tell you that this side is having a little bit more trouble. So I'm going to try to rest my head. It wants to lift. I'm going to slow down. I'm going to use my breath, and I'm not going to go as big. Feeling through my chest. Through my spine, my legs also want to separate. It's harder for them to lay still, but it's okay. It's why we do these kind of things. You're recognizing differences in your sides, needs that your body has for mobility. And we're gonna breathe in and out. We're gonna keep breathing in and out. There we go. And you'll notice the more you do this, even bits that felt a little tight and maybe a little bit wonky start to feel a heck of a lot better. Oh yeah, there we go. One more. Those are so good. So that's a thoracic reach around, if you will. Okay, now this one's gonna look funny. I need you to go with it, okay? Take your arms out wide like a T, and then you're gonna kick. You're gonna kick your leg from one side to the other. One side to the other. Try to keep your legs really long. You can bend your knees if you want. So if this feels better, to go side to side, this is another time you just get to play. So I want you to do one leg at a time. So tapping, rolling around, figuring out what feels good for you. And then you can even reach. So you can go like all the way over if you want to. This is playtime, mobility playtime, what feels good for your back. But we're just kicking side to side, or you can stay still, or you can bend your knee. Other leg. Now I know this is my touchy leg. or side rather. So I'm gonna bend here, I'm gonna roll, I'm gonna lean my shoulders down and kind of let both legs move side to side. So feel you're unlocking some tension and just honestly a lack of mobility in the lower back. We're not great there. We tend to have a lot of lower back pain from not having strong enough cores. I still want you to move and groove. And then maybe adjusting, maybe reaching a little bit if that feels playful and good. If it doesn't feel playful and good, OMG, don't do it. This is about feeling yummy right now. Okay, we're gonna take this, we're gonna roll over prone, so onto our belly. Super graceful. Basically a break dancer, you guys. We're gonna take a big breath and we're gonna do the same thing. So you're gonna kind of have to play with what your arms are doing. I don't have the chest flexibility to do that, but you're gonna kick back and then come to the front. Kick one leg over. You're gonna feel a nice little hip opener here as well. Try to keep your forehead just relaxed and calm. Feel how this different positioning, this prone positioning affects this move. Just two more. You should have this wonderful warmth going down your spine, all down your back. Feels so good. One more. Other side now. Adjust. And as always, if you can't do the full range here, maybe you can't tap your toe, it doesn't matter. As long as you're working in your range of motion with your mobility, keeping your core nice and activated, using your breath, working on your mobilization and your journey, right? We're all at different stages. I'm gonna do two more. Body feels nice and warm and open. Last one. And then listen really carefully. I want you to come to child's pose. Oh, and just feel your upper back. So as you press your hips back towards your heels, I'm even gonna tuck my toes and come to puppy pose and just feel. And then extend, just hang out here. You can move a little bit and kind of roll your head side to side. I hope your back feels good. I hope your spine feels worked. You can continue to build on that. As you do the video more and more, the movements more and more, you'll kind of find your sweet spot. And you'll notice big changes in your mobility over time. Coming up to a nice kneeling position, a little gentle release. Amazing, feels so good. Oh, have a wonderful day. I hope you enjoyed that time.